All right, so we have five references. So what I'm going to do now is, let's just assume that this is 200 references that you've built up. So you're going to keep doing this search process, building your reference library, collecting the papers, the PDFs, and then later you'll go and sit down and read all those papers. You'll spend a few hours reading, and then you'll make notes on them and decide which ones are the important ones that you're going to cite. So what we're going to do now is switch over to Microsoft Word, and we're going to start typing our paper. Okay, so let's assume you've written an entire paragraph here. And so as you're writing these sentences, you want to cite references. So earthworms live in the soil. And I'm going to put a space there because that's where I'm going to drop in the citations. So I will switch back to EndNote. So you click one, and then if you need to select two or three references, you can hold down the command button and select other ones that are not necessarily next to each other. So I've selected two references. Now I'll go back to Word, and I've already installed when I installed EndNote on my computer, I also installed the add-in into Microsoft Word. So now I can go here to EndNote X9, click that, and then I go over to Insert Citation, and then I pull down the menu, Insert Selected Citations. So I click that, and then instantly what happens is the two citations go in, and it starts to build my bibliography. Yeah, so that's pretty awesome. I didn't have to type any of that. Now, the second sentence, we say they are beneficial to plants. So we're going to put some citations there. Switch back to EndNote. And I'm going to select the other three. Switch back to Word. Insert selected citations. Okay, so now it has 1 and 2, 3 through 5, and all five of them are showing up here. All right, that's awesome. So now I can put my references subheading there and just keep going. Just keep writing and citing, writing and citing. Now, one thing that we're going to notice is this is just a style that's putting the references as number one and number two, or three through five. So let's say your target journal doesn't do it by number, it does it by name. Okay, so we're going to need to change that. So what you can do is go up here, and it's set for numbered. And what we're going to do is select a different style. Okay, so I'm going to say select another style. All right, and when you do that, it pops up this window. Sometimes your journal is not on the list, and you'll have to figure out how to add it to the list. That's not that hard to do. You just have to Google and find out how to do it. Scroll down here and find Planta, and I choose that. Okay, so now it goes into the Planta format, and it has the names and the years instead of just numbers. And you see it's completely reformatted all of the big bibliography. So another thing you need to do is go through the bibliography and make sure it matches with the instructions for your target journal. So I can see at least one problem right now, and that's right here in the title of plant disease. It didn't capitalize the D in disease. It should be capitalized. So I could fix it here in Word, but that's not a permanent fix because when I update this, it goes right back to the lowercase. Why does it do that? It does that because I didn't update my source material, my EndNote library. So I have to go into EndNote, and so I'm going to open that reference, and then I'm going to type and correct that typo. All right, and then I close it and save it. And then if I go back to Word and I update, then it's correct. Okay, plant disease is now correct. So this is one of the drawbacks of using Google Scholar. It tends to not always capitalize all the words of the titles. And so you have to do corrections for that. The other thing to look for is italics on the species names. A lot of times when you copy these references over, the italics don't come over with it, and you have to go into EndNote and correct that. So that's true with any of these reference managing software packages. It's not an EndNote specific thing. Okay, well, I hope that's helpful. So let's review what we looked at today. We looked at how to go into Google Scholar and find source material, get the PDFs of those papers in many cases, how to import the reference into the reference library, how to start with that one reference and expand the search in different directions, past and related articles and by author. And we also looked at how to import the references into EndNote, how to take the references from EndNote and put them into Microsoft Word, build the bibliography, and change the target journal format when necessary. So now it's time for you to put this into practice. And it does take practice. I went through this very quickly, but you can watch the video several times and go out there and start finding your source material for your paper. Good luck.